Alright, Samsung's top-of-the-line Galaxy Note 20 Ultra, which was launched in 2020, is an amazing phone and I've been using it for the past 6 months as daily driver. In this video, I would like to share my experiences with this phone and I will tell you the pros and cons of this device. Perhaps this video might help you decide whether to consider buying this phone in 2021. We already know that Samsung is skipping this year's Note series due to multiple reasons which I have already discussed in one of the previous videos. Just in case if you have missed it, I have left the link in the description. Now here in this video, I don't want to stress on the specifications of this phone. Instead, I will share my opinions and thoughts about it. First thing is of course the design. The one I have here is Mystic Bronze color, which is in matte finish or let's say frosted glass finish, which looks good and feels good in the hands. Having said that, I do put a case on it all the time to protect this device, which costs about $1,300 even today. Even though this phone gets Gorilla Glass Victus on its front and back, which is the most shatterproof glass on a phone till date, I do not prefer using it without a case on it. I use this Spigen thin fit case, which keeps the phone's form factor intact while it provides a good drop protection as well. The in-hand feel without the case feels good, but since the edges are too sharp, it becomes a little uncomfortable. So in the case, it is more comfortable feeling. Now coming to this camera bump, it is definitely huge. It is so huge that sometimes when I make a video keeping the phone flat on the table, I keep something underneath towards its bottom just to make the phone sit flat. It's that huge. Even some of the cases don't protect it completely, so you should be careful while considering a case. Just make sure the case's camera module protector is protruding outwards to keep it safe when the phone is kept on a flat surface. Now, the display is something which is obviously beautiful and I don't have to tell you much about it if you are coming from Samsung. That 120Hz refresh rate is buttery smooth. Anyone would love consuming media or playing games on this display. The only change you would notice on the display if you are coming from its predecessor is that the color accuracy is much improved on this display. When you keep a Note 10 Plus or a Note 9 next to this display, the blacks and colors pop out on them, whereas on Note 20 Ultra, perhaps it's been tuned to offer more natural colors. Some people may not like it. In fact, even when I saw it for the first time, I instantly felt that this AMOLED panel is a bit different and I didn't really like it. But after some time, I realized and felt it's a better display offering better color accuracy. So now I definitely like it. And certainly there is a big difference in the display compared to its predecessors. Now, coming to the cameras, of course, when we see such a huge camera bump and those huge lenses with big spec numbers, we would expect great photos and videos, and this module doesn't disappoint us. It's a sophisticated setup offering some great quality images and videos. A wide range of video resolutions on offer. You want 8K at 24fps, you have it. You want 4K at 30fps or 60fps, you have it. And any other lower resolutions, you have them. The photos up to 108MP can give you some amazing detailing. We have a wide angle, an ultra wide angle and a periscope lens. The first two lenses definitely serves the purpose, but I always felt that the periscope or telephoto lens, which offers 50x zoom, is just a gimmick. Yes, it makes sense having an optical zoom up to 5x, but 50x zoom, I hardly use it once in a while. When I realize, oh yeah, my phone can zoom distant objects, but then just to realize that it's so blurry, so what's the point in having 50x zoom capability, right? Still, you can have some fun zooming into your neighbor's house maybe, if you're really interested in that. Anyways, this is a great camera system, but no camera system gets a clean sheet. I will come to it in a bit when I talk about cons. Now coming to the performance, no doubt it's a beast. Maybe the Exynos 990 or the Snapdragon 865 Plus, it performs really well. Throw any graphic intensive games at any high resolution, we can play without any issues. Day-to-day tasks run smoothly. Of course, this line of phones are meant to do that as they are the most capable ones. In this department, I never had any issues whatsoever. Okay, now this being a note, the S Pen is something which I must talk about. With its Air Actions and the lowest latency of 9 milliseconds, makes it the most advanced S Pen till date. If you're already a note user, you would know the benefits of having an S Pen. Maybe writing a quick note on the lock screen, taking a screenshot and editing it, extracting, copying text, saving multiple notes in folders. There are so many more functions associated with it, which are really useful in day-to-day life. and the Air commands is not something I use, but using S Pen to click selfies is something which is thoughtfully done. If you are switching to this phone from Yes series or any other phones without a stylus, you are gonna love it for sure, and once you know the real power of S Pen, you will continue using the Note series. I think now I'm sounding like I'm reviewing an S Pen, so let's move ahead. Now, coming to the speakers, it has one of the best sounding stereo speakers. There is no vibrations or crackling when you hear it in full volumes. Alright, so these are my positives about this phone. Now let's talk about some cons as well. The first major con I would say is the battery performance. I'm not really sure why. Since the day I got this phone, I've been getting an average of 4 to 5 hours of screen on time on 120Hz display and about 6 hours of SOT on power saving mode with 60Hz Full HD. Of course, we do understand that it's a bigger display with high refresh rate, etc. But the problem here is the size of the battery. For such a big phone, Samsung has offered just 4500mAh battery, which could have been at least 5000mAh. But that's what it is. With this, I could manage a day on a moderate usage, but if you are a heavy user, you will have to recharge it much before the end of the day. I wouldn't say the battery performance is too bad, but it should have been better. I suppose the Snapdragon version offer better battery life. If you are a Snapdragon user, do leave a comment and let the community know about the performance of the battery. Next con for most people is not having an option to set 120Hz refresh rate and WQHD at the same time. In my opinion, this setup is actually going to save battery. Having a 45mAh battery on Exynos 990 with maxed out resolution and refresh rate is going to drain the battery very quickly. That being said, it is still a con. Next one I would like to point out is the autofocus. It sometimes doesn't focus the subject quickly, especially in low light conditions while taking a video. I've been having some trouble with it, at least on the unit that I have here. The laser autofocus sensor, which is fitted on the camera module, should have improved the focus accuracy, but it is not doing it. Even while shooting a video of a still object, when you move the phone around, it doesn't keep the frames constant. Next one is the S Pen positioning. I would definitely prefer it on the bottom right corner, being a right-handed person. It's not a big deal, but yes, in my opinion, it would have been nice to have it on the right-hand side. Then the 25W fast charger. Are you serious? 25W charging speed for a top-of-the-line phone, that's definitely a disadvantage for me. The last con I would like to mention is that the ultrasonic fingerprint sensor for some reason is not very responsive on my unit. Not sure about you guys, do let me know your thoughts about it. Alright, so these are some cons about this phone, but they are not something which should stop you from buying it. It is an incredible Note made by Samsung, and since there is no Note coming this year, Note 20 Ultra will remain the top of the line Note even in 2021. Now, as far as the price is concerned, many of us are expecting a big drop like it happened with Note 10 Plus. But in my opinion, there will be some drop, but not to that extent. Not at least until the first quarter of 2022. Mainly because there is no Note launching this year, I'm sure Samsung would like to capitalize on the pricing. That's just my thought and I could be wrong here, you guys let me know. All in all, it's a fantastic package, it's been pleasure using this phone as a daily driver and I would recommend you to buy it once you see some price drop. Alright, that's about it. You guys let the Apex community know about your experiences and thoughts about this phone in the comment section below. Make sure to like, share and subscribe to the channel. Thanks a lot for watching. You guys take care and stay safe. I will see you in the next one. Cheers, bye-bye.